Hey guys, this is Huzaifa for my YouTube channel Positive Academy. In today's video, I am going to talk about It Works by RJ. I am doing the audio version of this book because this is just a short and simple book. So I thought, why not to share that idea, right? To attract anything in your life, right? It is a famous little red book that makes your dream come true. It Works by RJ is an amazing book. It has sold over 1.5 million copies over the world, right? So I'm just reading this book. I hope you enjoy this video. If you would like to know more about positivity stuff, please consider subscribing to my channel to receive the regular dose of positivity. This book, which is valuable message, is presented by RJ. It Works. All who joy would win must share it. Happiness was born a twin. Byron. It is a positive mental attitude publishing, a concise, definite, restful plan with rules, explanations and suggestions for bettering your condition in life. If you know what you want, you can have it. What is the real secret of obtaining desirable possessions? Are some people born under a lucky star or other charm, which enables them to have all that which seems so desirable? And if not, what is the cause of the difference in conditions under which men live? Many years ago, feeling that there must be a logical answer to this question, I decided to find out, if possible, what it was. I found the answer to my own satisfaction, and for years, I have given that information to others who have used it successfully. From a scientific, psychological, or theological viewpoint, some of the following statements may be interpreted as incorrect, but nevertheless, the plan has brought the results desired to those who have followed the simple instructions. And it is my sincere belief that I am now presenting it in a way which will bring more happiness and possession to many more. If wishes were horses, beggars would ride. It is the attitude taken by average men and women in regards to possessions. They are not aware of a power so near that is overlooked, so simple in operation that it is difficult to conceive, and so sure in results that it is not made use of consciously or recognized as a cause of failure or success. Gee, I wish that were mine, is the outburst of Jimmy, the office boy, as a new rat roster goes by, and Florence, the telephone operator, expresses the same thought regarding a ring in a jeweler's window. While poor old Jones, the bookkeeper, during the Sunday stroll, replies to his wife, "Yes, dear, it would be nice to have a home like that, but it is out of question. We will have to continue to rent." Landon, the salesman, protests that he does all the work, gets the short end of the money, and will someday quit his job and find a real one, and President Bonham, in his private sanctorum, voices a bitter tirade against the annual attack of hay fever. At home, it is much the same. Last evening, father declared that daughter Mabel was headed straight for disaster, and today mother's allowance problem and other trying efforts fade into insignificance as she exclaims, "This is the last straw. Robert's school teacher wants to see me this afternoon. His reports are terrible. I know, but I am late for the bridge now. She will have to wait until tomorrow." So goes the endless stream of expressions like this from millions of people in all classes who gave no thought to what they really want and who are getting all they are entitled or to expect. If you are one of these millions of thoughtless talkers or wishers and would like to decide a change from your present condition, you can have it, but first of all, you must know what you want, and this is not an easy task. When you can train your objective mind, the mind you use every day, to decide definitely upon the things or conditions you desire, you will have taken the first step in accomplishing or securing what you know you want. To get what you want is no more mysterious or uncertain than the radio waves all around you. Tune in correctly and you will get a perfect result. But for to do this, it is of course necessary to know something of your equipment and have a plan of operation. You have within you a mighty power, anxious and willing to serve you, a power capable of giving you that which you are honestly desire. This power is described by Thomson J. Hudson, PhD, LLD, author of The Law of Psychic Phenomena, as your subjective mind. Other learned writers use different names and terms, but all agree that it is omnipotent. Therefore, I call this power Emmanuel, God in us. Regardless of the name of this great power or the conscious admission of a God, the power is capable and willing to carry to a complete and perfect conclusion every earnest desire of your objective mind. But you must really in earnest about what you want. Occasional wishing or half-hearted wanting does not form a perfect connection or communication with your omnipotent power. You must be in earnest, sincerely and truthfully desiring certain conditions or things, mental, physical or spiritual. Your objective mind and will are so vacillating that you usually only wish for the things, and the wonderful capable power within you does not function. Most wishes are simply vocal expressions. Jimmy the office boy gave no thought of possessing the red roaster. Landon the salesman was not thinking of any other job or even thinking at all. President Bondum knew he had fever and was expecting it. Father's business was quietly like successful, and mother no doubt brought home first prize from the big party that day. But they had no fixed idea of what they really want their children to accomplish, and were actually helping to bring about the unhappy conditions which existed. If you are in earnest about changing your present condition, here is a concise, definite, restful plan with the rules, explanation and suggestions. The plan. Write down on paper in order of their importance the things and condition you really want. Do not be afraid of wanting too much. Go the limit in writing down your wants. Change the list daily, adding to or taking from it, until you have it about right. Do not be discouraged on account of changes, as this is natural. There will always be changes and addition with accomplishments and increasing desires. The positive rules of accomplishment. First, read the list of what you want 3 times each day, morning, noon and night. Second, think of what you want as often as possible. Third, do not talk to anyone about your plan except to the great power within you, which will unfold to your objective mind the method of accomplishment. It is obvious that you cannot acquire faith at the start. Some of your desires, from all practical reasoning, may seem positively unattainable. But nevertheless, write them down on your list in the proper place of importance to you. There is no need to analyze how this power within you is going to accomplish your desires. Such a procedure is unnecessarily as trying to figure out why a grain of corn placed in a fertile soil shoots up a green stalk, blossoms and produces an ear of corn containing 100 of grains, each capable of doing what one grain did. If you will follow this definite plan and carry out these principles, rules, the method of accomplishment will unfold quite as mysteriously as the ear of corn appears on the stalk, and in most cases much sooner than you expect. When new desires, deserving position or at or about the top of your list come to you, then you may rest assured you are progressing correctly. Removing from your list items which at first you thought you wanted is another sure indication of progress. It is natural to be skeptical and have doubts, distrust and questioning. But when these thoughts arise, get out your list, read it over, or if you have it memorized, talk it to your inner self about the desires until the doubts that interfere with your progress are gone. Remember, nothing can prevent you having that you have earnest desire. Others have things, why not you? The omnipotent power within you does not enter in any controversial argument. It is waiting and willing to serve when you are ready. But your objective mind is so susceptible to suggestion that it is almost impossible to make any satisfactory progress when surrounded by skeptics. Therefore, choose your friend carefully and associate with the people who now have some of the things you really want. But do not discuss the matter of accomplishment with them. Put down on the list of wants such as material things as money, home, automobile or whatever it may be. But do not stop there. Be more definite. If you want an automobile, decide what kind of style, price, color, and all other details, including when you want it. If you want a home plan, then structure, grounds, furnishing, decide on location and cost. If you want money, write down the amount. If you want to break a record in your business, put it down. It may be sales record. If so, write the total, the date required, and the number of items you must sell to make it. Also, list your prospects and put after each name the sum expected. This may seem very foolish at first, but you can never realize your desires if you do not know positively and in detail what you want and when you want. If you cannot decide this, you are not in earnest. You must be definite, and when you are, results will be surprising and almost unbelievable. A natural and ancient enemy will no doubt appear when you get your first date of accomplishment. This enemy is discredit, in a form of such thoughts as, it can't be possible. It just happened to me. What a remarkable coincidence. When such thoughts occur, give thanks and assert credit to your omnipotent power for the accomplishment. By doing this, you gain assurance and more accomplishment, and in time prove to yourself that there is a law which actually works at all times when you are in tune with it. Sincere and honest thanks cannot be given without gratitude, and it is impossible to be thankful and grateful without being happy. Therefore, when you are thanking your greatest and best friend, your omnipotent power, for the gifts received, do so with all your soul and let it be reflected in your face. The power and what it does is beyond understanding. Do not try to understand it, but accept the accomplishment with thankfulness, happiness, and strength, faith. Caution. It is possible to want and obtain that will make you miserable, that will wreck the happiness of others, that will cause sickness and death, that which will rob you of eternal life. You can have what you want, but you must take all that goes with it. So in planning your wants, plan that which are sure will give you and your fellow man the greatest good here on the earth, thus paving the way to that future hope beyond the pale of human understanding. This method of securing what you want applies to everything you are capable of designing and scope of being so great. It is suggested that your first list consists of only those things which you are quite familiar, such as amount of money or accomplishment or the possession of material things. Such desires as these are most easily and quickly obtained than the discontinuance of fixed habits, the welfare of others, and the healing of mentally or bodily ills. Accomplish the lesser things first, then take the next step, and when that is accomplished, you will seek the higher and really important objectives in life. But long before you reach this state of progress, many worthwhile desires will find their place on your list. One will be to help others as you have been helped. Greatest is the reward to those who help and give without thought of self, as it is impossible to be unselfish without gain. This is the conclusion. A short while ago, Dr. Emil Koch came to this country and showed thousands of people how to help themselves. Thousands of others proved an idea, refuses assistance, and are today where they were before his visit. So with the statement and plan presented to you now, you can reject or accept, but you can remain as you are or have anything you want. The choice is yours, but God grant that you may find in short volume the inspiration to choose aright. Follow the plan and thereby obtain, as so many others have, all the things, whatever they may be, that you desire. So this was a audiobook version of the It Works book. I hope you enjoy this content, right? So you can desire, or you can become what you want, right? You can attract whatever you desire, right? It is up to you. Do not give up and just continue fulfilling this. The plan is very important, which has been discussed in this book, right? I would recommend you just listen to this at least 2 to 3 times and become the... lead it to your subconscious mind so that it will be remembered forever, right? So this is Huzaifa from my channel Positive Academy, right? See you in the next video. Till then, bye. Also remember, you are the creator of your own life. You can become whatever you want. We are the multidimensional being having human experience, right? So this is Huzaifa signing. See you in the next video. Peace.